various ways. Where can the mind throw out the impressions? Through the body, sense organs, ears. It will create images. It will make the body itching. Okay. Try to ignore. Okay. As much as possible, because as you ignore, the impression will go. That will not be stored. Understand? These karmic impressions are like people. Okay. If you talk to somebody, that he will become friend. Okay. If you ignore somebody, he will go away. The impressions will keep coming. I want to move my leg and all. Watch, because you are not the body, you are the sakshi. Then what will happen? These impressions will slowly go in from life. You will be able to sit longer and longer duration without any disturbance. Clear? Any questions? So, this is the purpose. Morning we will try to, there are many techniques. We will only focus on two techniques today. One is breath observation and other is who am I in the afternoon. Okay. So those who know vipassana, those who have done vipassana, can continue to do vipassana and breath observation in the morning session, but focus on the atma vichara in the afternoon session. Clear? Just 1 minute. So I'll just two stories before we start. One day Buddha and disciple Ananda were going. So there was a river, there was a lake. Buddha said, I'm thirsty. So Ananda said, I'll get water, but he goes to the water lake and the water is muddy. Some bullock cart has passed and the water has become muddy. So Ananda comes and says, we can't drink water, it's muddy. So Buddha says, let us sit for some time. The mud settles and water is available to drink. Like that, the mud in the mind has to settle down. You have mud in the mind, lot of mud in the mind because of interaction with the world. You have to allow the time to settle down. Number one. Okay, it takes quite some time and quite effort to present. There will be clear water. The clear water where you can see bottom. That is actually pure consciousness, pure awareness, Narayana. So what you have to learn? How to let go, how to wait, how to watch. Okay, don't keep on disturbing. Alright? So how do you stop disturbing? There's one story. In a Buddhist monastery, people who are practicing meditation, okay, they have to take a vow of silence. Only once in 10 years they can talk. Okay, so a new monk comes. So after 10 years, he'll go to the guru and say, the bed is too hard. Guru says, okay, change the bed. After 20 years, he says, food is not good. Okay, change the food. After 30 years, he comes and says, there's too many mosquitoes. Idiot, he is talking too much, throw him out of the monastery. So here you don't have time to talk. We can't spend 10 years. Don't talk, no talking. And if you have anything to communicate, write in a slip and give to me on a piece of paper. The slip is available here. Okay. So I'll also write and give. Only at 5 o'clock in the evening we'll open our mouth. But of course, afternoon I'll give you instruction for Atma Vichara. Okay? So any questions? No talking, because the mind wants to come out. Okay? Through the mouth. Right? If you don't allow, the impression will come out in the other form. Images. If you ignore that and concentrate on breathing, that image, a karmic impression will disappear from your life. If you give attention to that, again it will go back, store, record. Clear? Everybody's clear? Can you start? Okay, let's start. So, just go, you want to go to restroom or anything, go 10 o'clock now, 11 o'clock we'll wait for the coffee.